Did someone say play a custom level? Did someone say that? I hope someone did because I'm playing a custom level. Lots of time by Koopa X V1.0. He always has to put V1.0. This level is a little exercise I made before returning to an abandoned facility. Enjoy! Okay. Apparently, okay, well, that's fucking great. I have to start. Okay, I have to precisely move into the two-time white area. Where have I seen that before? Okay, there we go. Wait. Oh, of course, okay. We had a long break. So it looks like this level has no plot for me to complain about, which is great, because I don't want to really complain about, okay, plot all the time. But now... Okay. Okay, there we go. We're back. Great, I love having a floor that I can't fucking see! So basically, Koopa X took the concept of, Destroy Chamber and, Destroy Chamber in the future and... You know... Clean Chamber. And, in the present from, Portal 2, except he reversed. It basically just reversed, you know, the past, like, now the Rune Chamber is the past, and, Clean Chamber is the future. I don't fucking get it. That makes no fucking sense. It's fucking retarded as shit, bruh. I fucking hate, okay. You know, I choose to play, like, the, you know, hard version because it's the original, so. Oh my fucking god. Alright, there we go, that wasn't so bad. What the fuck is this tile doing here? Okay, great. Well, at least he doesn't force you to do things over again. Fuck! Are you kidding me? I have to precisely move! This guy is a fetish for precise movement, I swear. Like every day, he gets up and wants to make challenges. I am quite precisely moved, not fucking much. Just like that's all he does. And this doesn't have much resemblance to like the original, you know, chamber. Like, it kind of looks like it, but it really doesn't. Like, even like change the tile set and all. So, of course, in the past, someone did this destroy. Okay, there you go. Cross two. Oh, nice missing tile here, retard. Do I really have to die to get to that checkpoint? What the fuck? This level is a piece of shit. Why do I have to die to get to that checkpoint? Okay, piece of shit, retards. Okay, Jesus. Oh yeah, that future side is supposed to be upside down, but I actually like being able to read things, so. But yeah, I played like the, I pretty much played the original version of a level. So like, if a level was originally hard and then some retard made an easy version of it, then I played a hard version. Cause fucking, I don't know. I don't trust people to fucking... That's funny, okay. You can skip past the fucking teleportation thing. What the fuck? Are you fucking kidding me? Seriously, though, why is like the past version the destroyed version? That doesn't make any sense. Oh, and also, I forgot to say this, but the past chamber, clean chamber, future chamber, rune chamber, it's like for Portal 2 is actually from the community maps. It's not anywhere in Portal 2. Okay, Portal 2 doesn't have any tribe travel. Guy also has a fetish for, you know, not putting checkpoints on anything. He's like, I like the level better when there's no fucking checkpoints on any fucking anywhere! But getting this checkpoint here removed my second checkpoint when I teleported, and now I teleported to the future, and now... So this room, you have to precisely move into a two-tile white area, not once, but twice! Where's this guy get off? Where's this guy get off? Like, are you not satisfied with having, like... At least one too tight wide area for you to have to precisely move to your level. Like seriously. Ah, yes, finally. Oh, now I have to move to a too tight wide area again. Great, alright. Oh my god, I can't fucking do it. Just can't. Why don't you move the fucking these three spikes over to the left a bit more so I can actually fucking do a fucking challenge? I swear. I swear. It's just it's gotta. Oh, so this guy seems to suffer from left click spike syndrome, spike spam syndrome. Like he picks a spike tool, left clicks everywhere, and oh great, you know, have a fucking level. That's what he thinks anyway, just like, oh my god, you have to move to a 2-tile wide area. 2-tile wide areas, they seem to be common in this level. This guy really likes this 2-tile wide area, so you have to... Oh great, I love being not able to see the floor. It's an absolutely merton of this being a fucking shitty piece of shit level. Jesus fucking Christ. Oh great, I have to move to the 2-tile wide area twice. There's no checkpoint here, so that's great. You know, I've learned how to see 2-tile wide areas. Just from the amount of times that people fucking abuse 2-tile wide areas in the fucking levels. Like, I can see them. Like, in between spikes, in between corridors, in between... Like, it's not that hard, but like... That's how I've learned to see them, because people fucking use 2-tile wide areas so fucking much. Especially this guy has a 2-tile wide area fetish. 2-tile wide fetish. Like, 2-tile wide spacing, let's call it. 2-tile wide spacing fetish. This is what this guy has. Fucking Creeper X, fucking piece of shit. I did wish that he was gonna burn in hell. That a hell that I create. And now I'm wishing he burns even more in that hell. I just make that hell hotter so he can fucking burn in it more. You know, people seem to do left-click enemy spam a lot, and the people seem to do left-click spike spam a lot. The one thing they never do is left-click checkpoint spam a lot, because why would you put checkpoints in your levels? That's what makes things fucking very fucking difficult for the player to do. So I'm gonna just play waste more of his time on this fucking stupid piece of shit level, but I'm forcing him to fucking... Do your fucking challenges over and over again. Do challenges he's already completed over and over again. So you get here. You enjoy the full level experience. The full level experience is just the fucking player doing the challenges over and over again because you don't fucking put enough checkpoints in your fucking being the shit levels. finally, Jesus Christ. I'm saving there. Fuck you. I mean, if you notice in, the main game, like, Terry never, like, or whoever designed Mega, I don't fucking know, but its creator never, like, left-click spike spam, like, try to cover a lot of surfaces with spikes. He softly thought out where the spikes should be, you know? And then covered entire surfaces, but, like, he didn't cover every fucking surface that the player wouldn't be standing on. Okay, I have to move into a 2-tile space again. 2-tile wide space. Precisely moving into 2-tile white spaces, the movie. No, but the level of the movie. Precisely moving into 2-tile white spaces, the level of the movie. I'm gonna do this like twice in this fucking room. Worst part is you can't even see where you're going to like be in another room. If you go to the other room. So, oh, great, like it's like that right there. But yeah, like the worst part is that you can't even see, so you have to just fucking guess where your horizontal position should be when you move into the other room, and if you don't get it right, well then fuck you, you're going to die, you have to do the entire fucking precisely moving challenge over and over again! I mean, that above room would cause dropping the player onto spikes that he didn't expect. Because there are spikes there that, you know, are just like randomly placed that the player doesn't know about. Okay, finally. I love being not able to see the floor. And again, this guy can't stop with this wanting to precisely move. The 2-top area. Look, it is! It's the 2-tile wide space. I have to move into it. I don't know why. Why do you like two tile white spaces so much, Creeper X? I swear you must have a fetish for them or something. Okay, he can't just make a level without them. No, he has to like shove them into every naked crater of this fucking stupid piece of shit level. Oh great. He doesn't put a fucking checkpoint anywhere, so I have to do the entire challenge over again. Guy also has a fetish for not putting checkpoints in this fucking level. He has also a fetish for left click spike spam. This guy has a fetish for making shitty levels! I swear! I can just come up with a fetish about anything. That's what he gets after he fucking making shitty levels. This guy has a fetish for making his levels as hard as possible. Like, he really appreciates it when some random American comes and fucking makes a shitty video about a stupid piece of shit level, and it calls him a fucking asshole for creating a fucking piece of shit level. And that's why he really likes that, you know. That's what he gets off to, being called names, being fucking bullied, being a dinner asshole, so other people can be an asshole to him. Like that's what he gets off to. Seriously, why is this level so fucking hard? Okay. Please don't make any more hard levels in the future. Okay, thanks, bye. Okay, really, all that little teleporting to the past future is just teleporting to another part of the level. Okay? Like, the only novelty is like the whole fancy effect of teleporting to the past or future. That's all it is. You're just teleporting to another part of the level. That's all you're really doing. In terms of a gimmick, it's like, it's on par with retextured spikes. You don't really only... You're not like doing much, okay? Like, mechanically. So unless you actually do something mechanically. Like, that, not even like, oh, affecting the past affects the future. But I don't know, that's just like a simple, like, basic, like, logic parts of a level. Like, that can be replicated in any level, and you don't have to label that, you know, time travel to the past and future. Finally! Alright, better be spikes here. Okay, great, there aren't. Okay, there's a two-tower wide spacing. Where have I seen one of those before? Oh, okay, great. So there's just an area where the game says, fuck you. Fuck you for coming up here. I hope you fucking die. I hope you kill yourself. Well, you know what, game? I hope you kill yourself, and I hope the creator of your fucking stupid level kills himself. So, I'm throwing it out there. He should probably, you know, die. This, you know, death would be like a mercy, you know, like pretty good mercy for what the fuck is this? Okay, great. Oh great, I have to travel last into stuff. There are like two participation trinkets over there. Or at least one of them does a participation ticket, because you get two tickets for basically nothing. Of course, this guy doesn't want to put checkpoints anywhere. No, putting checkpoints, so people! Putting checkpoints in this level would make the level easier! And here's a fetish for making levels hard! But this guy just you know, puts a lot of checkpoints in this level. I like the playtest! And then he just removes them, because he decided to, you know, fuck people who... We're gonna make it. Oh, great. Alright, and this is part of the again. Okay, great. Alright, now I've moved to two tile wide space. Okay, there. Alright, so all in all, the level. It's just like. It's. Time travel thing. It's just an over. It's like a glorified teleportation to another level. To another part of the level. Like, that's all it is. And there's like a lot of left click enemy spam. No, there's no enemy spam. There's no enemies on the level. I just realized that. I guess that's unique, but there's a lot of left click spike spam, and not enough left click checkpoint spam, not enough checkpoints. There's at least one participation trinket. No, this is pretty shit level.